For generations, my family has sailed the seas. Since before my grandfather's time, it has been our destiny. And now, it is mine. One day I went sailing and found that my old boat had sprung a small leak. I patched the hole with wood from another boat. At 12, my uncle made me an apprentice aboard his ship. Standing between land and sea, I felt like a man for the first time. Anticipating a life on the open sea, I dreamed of battle and glory on the horizons. But life is difficult in the Royal Navy, far removed from dreams of glory. Remembering my father's lessons, I worked hard to impress the crew. In time, I was made a midshipman, beginning new responsibilities. I drilled the men relentlessly and made sure we had the most accurate gunners in the fleet. We were forged together in the crucible of battle. For gallantry, I was recommended for promotion to the rank of lieutenant. But first, I must pass the lieutenant's exam. I was summoned before a board of captains. After a lengthy examination, they asked me what I thought the Navy's greatest strength was. The fleet, I said, for no other navy possesses our numbers or our technology. They nodded their heads in assent, then asked me for my appraisal of the navy's current strategic situation. Our fleet is admirable, but our enemies are always looking for an advantage to use against us. An old, grey-haired captain asked me about my skill in the organization of amphibious operations. I've read many books about tactics and strategy, and I am confident in my ability to command. The board applauded my answers and took a moment to reach their consensus. "Congratulations, sir," they said. "You have just made lieutenant."
Thank you.